I want to talk to you about the Aranya dog. It is not a recognized dog breed. It was an initiative of a kennel that trained and sold Dutch type of dogs, and they needed a dog that would be less big in size, so more compact, and more importantly, very reliable with children. Whereas the shepherd breeds and the herder breeds that they use might be a little bit, snappy. That's all Malinois or other working shepherd owners can attest. There is a chance that the dog becomes snappy. Also, they will try when they mature to test their owners to see who's boss, to get higher up in the hierarchy, so to become the boss if possible. And that's not a good thing to combine with a dog that you want solely for the purpose of protection of young children. If those children are also the master of the dog or left alone with the dog. So they looked at dog breeds that were very friendly, and they picked a dog which has a lot of mass. So instead of a regular bulldog type of dog, they looked at American bullies, who are at least a big part bulldog, and they used a small version of that, a little bit pocket, or at least small version. I'm not an American bully kind of guy, so for me this is not the real way I would have approached a situation like this. But they did, and they used a good bigger kind of American bully in terms of mass, but kept the size down to not be too big. And I think they also used American bully that they already worked with as protection dogs. And then they had the trouble that it was still too big, and perhaps also they needed a dog with more working capability. And so they added the Petterdil Terrier to bring down the size, but also reintroduce working capability. So they bred like a miniature terrier bulldog companion that was not developed for combating wild. But now they try to see it as a dog that could be a deterrent, especially because of the big head for people with mall intent and would be very relaxed among children. Whereas, of course, goedemorgen. Hoi. Hoi hoi. Mooie fiets, hè? Ja! Ja, je mag zo ballen. Zo, een dog dat could also wrestle if needed. But each terrier and each bulldog type of dog, or even each shepherd, will love it when they have the opportunity. I will pause it now to get the ball. Get the opportunity to get something. Being a ball like this one. This is a Petterdil Terrier, huh? Or something else. Los. And you can see, even as small as they are, they still bring a nice determination. Yeah. And are really eager to get on the ball, but could also be used to do different kind of things. Whereas for me, introduction of just bulldog will bring mess. And you could have achieved a similar goal with two working breeds. I always imagined what a working type Malinois Petterdale cross would be like, next to a very intense. It's braaf. Blijf. Blijf. Wachten. Goed. Wachten, Spijkie. So that would be my choice, or even using Los Reyes Canario or other type of dogs. For example, a working Rottweiler would also be a good choice to mix, for example, with this type of smaller terrier type of dog. But if you look at those Piranha dogs, they just look like, yeah, some pocket bullies, in my understanding. But they go nice, and I also saw some demonstration that they bite the sleeve nice, and also sure they will bring a lot of mass, lots of food to the table. It's considered to their size. That's what the modern type of bulldog does. Caricature of a real working dog, and if you then bring a more terrier type in like this, you come closer to types of old that are still able to work. This is my 11 month old Petterdale Estacado. He's a male, it's also known as the black fell terrier. Developed to hunt and kill vermin, especially to draw foxes and badgers, and dispatch them if possible. Easier with foxes than it is with badgers, of course. Good, so that the piranha dog is a nice dog to see. Also nice that they thought about a children companion that would still bring protection and especially prevention, because if you see a dog, even if it's a small one, with that kind of big sided head, so a head of that big size, that can deter a lot of people. And more importantly, you don't get a dog that's a liability for your own children. And I think they managed to create a dog that has properties close to that of a Staffordshire Bull Terrier, which is also named the nanny dog and the children's protector. So this type of dog doesn't care that you come into the house normally, but does care if you mess with the family, especially the children. They are a big children friend, and also very gentle with them. Because of their fighting origin, they are very people friendly, and also have a high pain threshold, which is a good thing. Spikey! Kom. Ja. Goed zo. Los. Goed zo. It's have a big pain threshold, and I think they breed it close to the size of the modern type Staffordshire Bull Terrier because of all the bully influences that they used. They created a dog with a bigger head, and perhaps even a little bit better athletic possibilities as compared to a regular Staffordshire Bull Terrier. I also think that their strength lies in the fact that they made a dog that is able to work for protection, so it is probably a little bit more aggressive because of the American bully that was used for some generations for protection work. And also, why would you use an American bully for protection work if there are protection bred dogs available? I can only imagine if you need a dog to deter and to be a tough looking dog. So that's my take on that. Hope you liked it. Another close-up of my dog. And this is a pure Petterdale, and I think the Spirania mix were 50% Petterdale, 50% Bully. They said pit bulls or American Staffordshire Terrier, but the head is way too big. You see here a more harmonious head, not too big, not too small. But those have like freaking big heads. It must be bullies, and also the build is a lot different.